Back by popular demand.
Back by popular demand.
You are back, and I thank you for coming as well. You're obviously here for another day, so it was good to get you back in the studio. Let's jump straight to it.
Mm-hmm.
Beterbiev versus Yarde. What did you make of Yarde's performance?
It was, he done better than I thought he would. You know, kind of going into the fight week, there was a kind of feel, certainly at the press conference, that this was a different Anthony Yarde. But you see Beterbiev and you're just like, how do you beat this guy?
Yeah.
But on fight night, he did better than I expected. But watching it, as good a fight as it was, I never got the, you know, sometimes you can just tell an upset's in the air or something's changing. When Yarde had his successes, there was never a time where I felt, oh, he's going to do something. It was always kind of like, Beterbiev will still win.
Yeah.
There was never any doubt. It was just like, doesn't matter what he does, Beterbiev just seems just composed, in control. And even though Yarde's tagging him, he'll find a way.
Yeah, I said that as well on my live on Sunday. I said it was inevitable.
Oh, yeah.
Like, it just felt like, okay, congratulations to Yarde. And, you know, you landed some shots and you hurt him maybe a couple of times, or at least staggered him a couple of times. But it felt like Beterbiev was in full control. Mm-hmm. That's why I was, like, horrified with the scorecards. I think two judges had Yarde up.
Yeah.
And I'm like, wait, what second? I must be watching a completely different fight.
I think one judge had Yarde by a round, but I think the other judge had him by a couple of rounds. Like, it wasn't a close scorecard. I think he only gave Beterbiev a round or two, which is crazy when you think about it. Even the rounds where Yarde started it really well and buzzed Beterbiev, Beterbiev would just back
always
him in the corner.
End it well, yeah.
But he would just, I mean, light him up in the corner, and you're just thinking, he's going back on unsteady legs. How are you seeing this any other way?
Yeah, it felt like Beterbiev gave him the first, not gave him, but Yarde won the first minute of every round.
Yeah.
But then Beterbiev came on strong every single round. And the strength in which he came on strong, they were defining.
Like,
he got Yarde in the corner and always buzzed him in the corner, always.
It was kind of like, he would give Yarde that minute where he'd say, right, let me see what you have. And then he kind of almost say to himself, is that all? Wait and you see this. That was basically what it was like. And look, great performance by Anthony Yarde. And I think that it shows, I know he's not fought much since the Kovalev fight, but it shows the improvements. I mean, that's not the, that Yarde is a world apart from the Yarde who lost to Kovalev.
Yeah, honestly, this is a Yarde that you can see has stayed in the gym.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, again, not to bring it back to Chris Eubank Jr., but I've always said that I don't think Chris lives in the gym outside of fight camps, right?
No.
You can tell Yarde is in the gym with James Cook, with Tunde, and maybe other people as well that go unsort of spoken about behind the scenes, and he's working on stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Because I agree, you look at the Yarde against Kovalev and you look at the Yarde against Beterbiev, and Beterbiev is a harder fighter than Kovalev, and you have to say it's light and day. My issue now with Yarde is, okay, what next? Do you stay at this level? And when I say this level, I mean sort of top 10?
Mm-hmm.
Or do you do what you did after the Kovalev defeat and really drop off? What do you do? Like, what's the plan, Frank? What's the plan, Tunde?
Well, Frank's been talking about Joe Smith Jr. Now, that is, I mean, I think it's fair to say, a bit like welterweight, you have Bivol and Beterbiev. They are the elite. They're special.
Yeah.
Joe Smith Jr. is still world level.
Yeah.
He's a big, hard-hitting, light heavyweight.
Former champion.
That's not an easy fight for Anthony Yarde. That's not a gimme. So, Frank Warren, if that is true and they are looking to go down that road, I mean, it doesn't get any easier. It's not like you're thinking, okay, easy comeback. That's far from easy.
That's a tough one as well, because Joe Smith's a big puncher.
Massive
as well.
Puncher.
And he'll look at Yarde, and although Yarde did well on Saturday, he'll look at that and think, give me that. I don't mind that. This is nothing I've not seen before. And Yarde, to be fair, will look at the performance that Joe Smith put in against Beterbiev and thinking, I'll take you as well.
Well, he'll look at that performance and say, you got blown out in two rounds. I had my successes. And, you know, he wasn't really ahead, but he could turn around and say, well, at least I was ahead in the scorecards. You got blown out in two rounds.
Yeah.
So would they look at that? I'd still love to see him and Bouatsi. That is a fight I've wanted to see for years. Years since they both.
Strange to see Bouatsi in the BT studios.
It was
very, very strange.
That,
honestly,
like,
people were reaching out to me and I, what's going on out there? Is there an issue with Matchroom? And I'm like, I have no idea. There probably is for him to be there, but I have no idea. But look, if he is going to join, like, I'm always, as much as I work for Matchroom and do some stuff for them and DAZN, like, I just want to see the best fight the best.
Yeah.
And if that means Bouatsi going over to BT Sports and making the Yarde fight, I'm all for it.
Yeah.
I'm all for it. It's a game. It's a bit like a Coley going to Boxer and potentially fighting Ryakpor.
Yeah.
I'm a boxing fan before I'm a company man, if you like. So I just want to see these fights happen. So I'm with you. Look, I would much prefer to see it be Bouatsi than a Joe Smith. I saw Marcus Brown on Instagram start to call people out as well. He wants to get back in the action. What did you make of the stoppage? Tunde jumping on the apron and saying enough's enough.
Well, it was inevitable. Like, I think it did look, especially at the end of the seventh round, that it was that inevitable was that what was going to happen. Seventh. Exactly. And I think Tunde, you know something, it, to me, we speak about Yarde growing as a fighter. I think Tunde's grown as a trainer. Mm-hmm. If that was the Tunde who was in there in the corner with Yarde against Kovalev, would he have got up on the apron and stopped the fight? That's a good question.
Very good question, you know. Very good. He might have said something like, it's a world title fight.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to put words in his mouth here, but this is the opportunity, you know, go for it type thing.
Yeah.
But against Beterbiev, he made the right decision because we know Beterbiev, if you look at the finishes recently, he's spiteful. And I spoke to Tony Bellew about this, and he said, Addy, it's the shots that you can't defend are the ones that give you the most damage. And mm-hmm. I felt like it got to a stage where I don't know if Yarde would have been able to defend himself.
No.
Imagine those rocks coming at you when he senses blood. It's actually horrible to think.
Beterbiev is the best finisher in boxing, probably.
I like
and
that.
And you have Yarde there who was badly hurt when he went down. He got up and he wasn't right. You could see it in his eyes.
He looked at the corner. Right. I thought he looked at the corner for almost a get me out of here.
Yeah, right, there was that look at the corner.
Yeah, there was a weird look, wasn't it? Like, what? Maybe he was buzzed and he didn't know what was going on, but he gave Tunde a reason to step up onto the apron. Yeah.
And I'm glad that Tunde did, because personally, I had no issue with it. I was thinking, you know, thank God he's not going to get badly, devastatingly hurt, you know? So I think it shows how much growth happened to the team.
Yeah.
You know, we all say, like, that wasn't the Yarde who fought Kovalev. You know, it was a much improved Yarde. And I think it's a much more mature Yarde. And that Tunde, given all the bravado going into the Kovalev fight, he was quiet. He said that. And the Tunde of 3.5 years ago, I don't think he would have stopped. I think he would have said, if Yarde had survived the 8th round, go back out and see what happens.
Yes, completely different Tunde. Mm-hmm. Again, credit to James Cook, another experienced voice in the corner as well. And look, I hope Tunde gets his plaudits, because we're quick to kick him when he, you know, chats a little bit of, you know, shit sometimes. Yeah. But he done very well on Saturday. I think his corner advice was good. And in the end, as you said, it was inevitable. And he's right to jump on the apron. So much chatter after the fight about Callum Smith. Obviously, look, he's WBC mandatory, but there's a lot of talk of Callum Smith will beat Beterbiev. And I'm like, oh, steady on. This guy's had 19 fights, 19 wins, 19 knockouts. And all of a sudden, you're talking about people that can beat him. I get it if you're Sam Bivol, but anyone else, I'm not going to entertain anyone else yet. I can't entertain it.
No, and I've seen a few people say that as well. Yeah. And look, Callum Smith is a good fighter. He's a very good fighter. And he's looked devastating at 175 pounds. Mm. But he's not hard to hit.
Mm.
He's not been in. Like his last fight where he had that knockout against that European guy.
Yeah.
He was getting hit a lot. Mm. And that guy did not have...
Yeah, that was a bit of a toe-to-toe war.
That was
war.
A toe-to-toe, yeah. And I think the fact the guy had no punching power played into Callum Smith's hands. If you go toe-to-toe like he did with Artur Beterbiev, it's going to be a short night. It's a very short night. Mm. And I think that Beterbiev is good at getting underneath shots.
Yeah.
He is going to back Callum Smith up to the ropes. And I wouldn't want to be Callum Smith in that situation at
all. And look, I know Callum's not the same guy that fought Canelo. It's a different training team. But if small Canelo, and Canelo is small compared to Beterbiev, can push you back, then I think we saw how Beterbiev pushed Yarde back. He can push Callum Smith back as well. All right, the million-dollar question, Bivol, Beterbiev. We've seen Bivol now against Ramirez and Canelo. We've seen Beterbiev against the likes of Vozdik and Marcus Brown and Yarde and Joe Smith. Who's the number one light heavyweight and who do you think wins that fight?
Right now, number one in the division has got to be Beterbiev.
Agreed.
But I would edge Bivol.
Mm.
I think the speed is going to be a match.
He's not getting backed up by that.
He's not getting backed up.
Yeah.
And I think that the speed he has, the judge of distance he has, it's just... The only thing is, though, the strength and sheer size of Beterbiev. You know, Ramirez looked two divisions heavier, but he never used any of his size.
Yeah.
But when he did decide to lean on Bivol a bit, he had success.
Yeah.
Beterbiev, that strength and size and that power, I mean, it is literally a case. And we've seen speed versus power of Beterbiev and Vozdik.
Mm.
And we know power came out on top that time.
It's a good shout. It's a good shout because Vozdik was going in there as, again, part of that Ukrainian national setup with Usyk and Lomachenko. Fantastic boxer. Great feet, a bit like Bivol. Good hand speed. And even he, towards the end, got tired and had to engage.
Yeah.
Soon as he got tired and engaged, we saw what happened. Beterbiev was down on the scorecards on that one. So I can almost see it. And I'm a big Bivol fan, but I can see Bivol winning the rounds. And you're thinking, this is easy work.
Yeah.
But then Beterbiev will get to him. There's going to be a time in that fight where Beterbiev and Bivol exchange in the middle. There has to be.
There has to.
And that's my fear for Bivol. That's my big fear.
And I think with Bivol, he's been, look, Bivol's a tremendous fighter, he is. But in those fights against Canelo and against Ramirez, both fighters fatigued themselves.
Yeah.
And they didn't push the action. Beterbiev is tremendous at just, even though he's knocked out everyone he's fought, he's tremendous at just doing what he needs to do in the rounds to conserve enough strength to have an attack. He's not just going to be like, okay, I'm getting tired now. What do I do? Just hold on. He's not going to do that.
Yeah, yeah. What do you think it happens this year or not?
I hope it does. But I think there's too many. I think there's between the mandatory to the WBC, with the Canelo rematch, I think
even
we're looking
at next broadcasters, year.
Different broadcasters.
Bob Arum, Bob Arum hates Eddie Hearn.
And see, here's the thing. Beterbiev by next year will be 39.
And this is what I don't
That's
want.
What I don't want.
I don't want it. It's got to be now. Like, I don't want a 39-year-old or even a 40-year-old taking on a Bivol or a Callum Smith. He's got. This is the year for me.
If we leave it go another year or two, right, it's going to be a case of Dmitry Bivol will probably win. No, he might not, you don't know, but you'll always be able to say, well, you fought Beterbiev when he was 39, when he was 40.
Yeah.
What if you would have fought him when he was 36, 37, what would have happened? Yeah. There's always going to be that kind of little caveat.
And I don't want that. Like, oh, I don't want that. It's kind of what we got with Canelo and GGG.
Yeah,
I don't. I don't want that. This is an undisputed fight. Let's make it this year. Like, I don't really care about the belts because we know who number one and two are, and it's these two.
Exactly.
It is a bit like you say, Spence and Crawford, where the number one and number two in a division, Usyk, Fury, are so clear. So look, let's hope it happens. But look, well done to Yarde. It was a big fight. He's there. He's world level. Does he stay there? Does he go back to what he normally does, C and D level? I hope not. Big thanks to G-Man for being in the building again. Don't forget, subscribe to his YouTube channel. Links in description. We want big numbers.
Big numbers.
We want big numbers. We're not playing 20K. Anymore. Not playing. 20K. Make sure you subscribe to his channel.